Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to print the odd numbers by using for loop in C++. So I'll be showing you two ways how you can do this. So let's get started. So first we'll be getting the number n from the user till which we'll be printing the odd numbers. So let me just have int n, and I will also have a cout saying enter n with a new line over here, which is endl. And let me input the number n. Alright, so the next line, let me just have a for loop int I equal to 1. So the starting value should be 1, because 1 is the first odd number, 0 is a neutral number, so don't have I equal to 0. And the condition is going to be I less than and equal to n. So this is the number that we are getting from the input, so we will be printing the odd numbers till that number. Okay, and next is going to be the increment operator. It's going to be I plus plus. So first let me just use the normal for loop, and later I will tell you how you can improvise this code and use it to print only odd numbers. So it's going to be C out I and a new line, which is endl. Okay, let me just now save it. So this will basically print the numbers from 1 to n. Okay, because I'm just iterating the value of I, and for each iteration I'm just printing it. Okay, so let me just now run this. So enter n, let me go with 10. So here you can see I'm getting numbers from 1 to 10. So why we are getting this is because of this increment operator. So what this increment operator does is that I equal to I plus 1. So this I plus plus is same as I equal to I plus 1. So during the first iteration, our I value is 1. 1 gets printed and it goes here I plus plus, which is I equal to I plus 1. I value was 1, so I equal to 1 plus 1 2. 2 gets printed, then it goes here I equal to I plus 1 again, but I value is 2 this time. I equal to 2 plus 1 3. 3 gets printed, then it goes again I equal to 3 plus 1 4 gets printed. I equal to 4 plus 1 5 gets printed. So it just goes on. So if I just now, you know, replace this I plus plus with I equal to I plus 1, we will be still getting the same output. So if I just now run it, and if I go with 10, so here you can see we will be getting the same output. So what we can do is, rather than having I equal to I plus 1, I have just changed this to I equal to I plus 2. So what this will do now is that first iteration, 1 will be getting printed. It comes here to the incrementation, I equal to I plus 2. I value is 1, so I equal to 1 plus 2, which is 3. It comes here, 3 gets printed. It goes here, I equal to 3 plus 2, 5 gets printed. Again goes I equal to 5 plus 2, 7 gets printed. So this goes on till value n. And by this way, we will be only able to print odd numbers. So we are just skipping the even numbers with the help of this incrementation by 2. I hope this really made sense. So let me just now delete this and clear it. And if I run this till 10, so here you can see I'm getting the odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Okay, so this is the first way, and let me just now move it to the back. Okay, I plus plus. And in the second way, we will be using a if condition. So I just have a if condition inside the for loop, and we need to enclose the cout inside this if condition. Okay, so just enclose this cout inside this if condition, and what we will do here is that we will just have I modulus of 2 equality 1. So any number when we do modulus of 2 gives the value 0 if that number is an even number. So the modulus operator just gives us the remainder. Okay, so for example 10 modulus of 2, 10 is perfectly divisible by 2, so we will, the remainder is going to be 0. Same with 4 also, 4 is divisible by 2, so no need of any remainders, right? But when we do modulus operation with an odd number by 2, we will be getting a remainder, because odd numbers are not perfectly divisible by 2. For example, 5 modulus of 2 will give the remainder as 1, and 7 modulus of 2 will also give the remainder as 1, 9 modulus of 2 will also give the remainder as 1. So the condition is that when we perform modulus operation by 2 to an odd number, that will always give us the remainder as 1. So whenever I is an odd number, it will give us a remainder as 1, and this condition will become true, and that I value will be getting printed. And whenever it is I is an even number, this will give us 0, 0 equal to 1, condition is false, so the print statement will never get executed. So only those I value will be printed if it is an odd number. So for example, during the first iteration, I value will be 1, 1 modulus of 2 is 1, so 1 equal to 1, condition is true, 1 gets printed over here, then I plus plus, I value becomes true, 2 modulus of 2 is 0, 0 equal to 1, condition is false, it doesn't go here, and gets incremented to 3, 3 modulus of 2 is 1, so 1 equal to 1, condition is true, 3 gets printed, then it goes here, incrementation 4, 4 modulus of 2 is 0, so 0 equal to 1, condition is false, 4 doesn't get printed, then 5, 5 gets printed, 7, 9, and it goes on. So this is just like a complex way. The first method was much more easier and much more faster than this method. So I will recommend you to follow the first method. Anyways, let me just show you this also. So if I run this, if I go with exact 10, here you can see we are getting the same output over here also. So I hope you would have found this video useful. I have done a lot of tutorials in C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL queries. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.